Mudit Gupta from Polymath, and I'll be talking about mixing-based privacy mechanisms and why they are insufficient. So we had a good intro about what mixing-based privacy mechanisms are just a few minutes ago, but I'll still go over them briefly. So there are two components to the mixers. One is masking the senders and receivers, and the other component is hiding the amount done in the transaction. The second component is actually done nicely in zero knowledge based mixers. So I'll be talking more about the first component. In how mixers work is basically they take different transactions and they put them in a tumbler that mixes them together and then releases the funds. So at the end of the transaction, you can never know which transaction was sent by whom to whom. So like for example, in this one, you can see green is supposed to send the transaction to green, yellow to yellow, blue to you, blue to blue. But after the mixer is done, everyone will receive their fund, but the outside world will never be able to know that green sent the transaction to green, blue or yellow. It could have been any one of those three. Now, in this example, the anonymity set is 3. That is basically the number of possibilities that a transaction can actually be. So the first disadvantage of such mixers is that the anonymity set is limited in size. So it's quite easy to attack. And churning can help in applications like Monero. It's just a pro tip. I don't have time to talk about this, but churning can help. If you are doing private transactions, do churning. Then the other thing is that analytic companies have more information than a normal user. For a normal user, maybe for me and you as well, a Monero transaction will probably be secure enough. But when the analytic companies get involved, they take the history of all the accounts, they can get data from big exchanges and stuff like that. So they have more data to de-anonymize your transaction. So in mixer-based transactions, if one transaction gets de-anonymized, the anonymity of other transactions is also reduced. So as I said in the last example, there were 3 people doing the transaction. If the third party knows one of those 3 people, even one of those, then the anonymity of the other 2 is reduced, because the anonymity set is then essentially reduced to 2 transactions rather than 3. So when the big corps are involved, they know about transactions done by different people, they know information about many transactions, so the anonymity set is reduced for them. Like they know most of the transactions already, they just need to figure out the remaining ones. Then the bad actors can poison the anonymity set. So if I'm a bad actor, I can spam the network with my own fake transactions. So in those transactions, I obviously know the sender and the receiver. So if the other party will use my transactions to mask their own transactions in an anonymity set, then their anonymity will be reduced, because they are actually using known information rather than private transactions. A big enough network. Now this one is actually not an on-chain exploitation, but something that can happen, and I've seen it being used. So when in a system like Monero, you can deploy 50 nodes and then you'll have a good view of the whole network. And then you can start listening to transactions involving, let's say, Alice. So you see Alice is involved in 100 transactions. Then you figure out which of the Monero nodes got those Alice transactions before others. So with enough data, you can figure out, like if Alice is using only one of her private nodes, you can figure out which node Alice is using. It's not a foolproof method, but it can be done with enough resources. Once you figure out which node is Alice's, you can get more information using the IP address of that node and other stuff. Now, some example of the previous attacks. One was an attack done on Wasabi just a few months back. So one of the attackers started reusing addresses. That is bad for everyone else, because a reused address reduces anonymity of every transaction. So yeah, and you can read more about this in this tweet. The other attack I want to talk about is more interesting, Flood XMR. So it was basically a similar attack in which the attacker flooded Monero with transactions over 12 months, and by using only $1,800, they were able to flood Monero with enough transactions to completely de-anonymize almost 50% of Monero transactions, and they reduced anonymity of 90% of the transactions. And Monero is right now the state of the art when it comes to live privacy mechanisms. So I just want to say that it's not a foolproof method, but you must know that mixing based privacy mechanisms are awesome, but they are not a foolproof method. Don't blindly trust them, especially when it comes to mission critical stuff. You should know your risk and proceed accordingly. Unfortunately, I don't have time, but feel free to catch me outside if you want to discuss me. Thank you.